if anybody's called Graham here, you'll know what I'm talking about, the Anthropocene or any of those names. Now, we are famous for Kim and Willie Armstrong escaping from here in June 1596. He was a notorious Scottish border raver who was captured on a truce day, brought here to Carlisle Castle. It's well documented. Sir Walter Scott himself made quite a lot of the story, and actually then romanticised the ballad of Kinmont Willie. Quite frankly, you can still see the gate where he sprung from. It wasn't a great raid from north of the border led by Walter Scott of Buccleuch. Basically, Walter Scott of Buccleuch did come down here to Carlisle Castle. He really couldn't get in here, but he had people on the inside, Grahams. And they jemmied the door to the Possum Gate, and Kinmont Willie escaped that way. We know this because we still have a bill for repair of the Possum Gate, and it was jemmied from the inside. If you want to see that Possum Gate, it's still there to this day. It's behind Eaker Block in the Outer Ward. And if you look at the ironwork that's on it now, they were going to make sure that nobody else jemmied the thing from the inside or indeed the outside if you ever see that gate. The Water River story I enjoy most is the story of Richie Graham. He was captured by the young Lord Dacre in 1527, brought here in chains, and was to be hanged the following morning. He was in this very room here in chains when he asked to go to the toilet, which is the guardrobe in the far corner. Richie said, yeah, I can go to the toilet, but can you take these shackles off? So the guards, not thinking anything of it, thought, well, where's he going to go from here? Took the shackles off and he went down into the guard room. And what did he do? He went down the toilet. He actually slid down the guard room, the chute, the hole, into a huge big pile of, into the cesspit. And he managed to swim way across all of that, broke the crust hopefully, so that he could get across it, and out of the cesspit, over the wall, and out of Carlisle, and he was never captured again. No one would have got to escape, no one would touch him, he'd be covered in his real what. So that was Richie Graham. He escaped from Carlisle Castle, did it all himself by swimming through a big pile of exactly. So that was Richie Graham in 1527. We're going to go through here now.